Oh boy. Little birdie tells me that little bear is back at it again and he brought a friend. Oh man. This is one of those videos I would prefer to just give you a face-to-face rundown of what occurred, but unfortunately, the context is incredibly crucial in order for us to proceed forward. So I am forced to react to this content creator's video. I gotta let him cook so that he can explain everything to y'all. I can't sum this up. It's too many details. It's too critical. So we're gonna react to the whole thing, boys. Buckle up. We're in for a roller coaster. By the way, this guy's name is ZMM. If you want to go and watch the video for yourself, let's get into it.
Ruined anyone's hype for Dr. Ratio because I want to discuss a serious topic today. I want to talk about the worst people I have encountered so far from my experience in Honkai Star.
Oh, I got a couple names that come to mind. Ooh, that Tectone, that bald white man, always getting on the internet and chasing drama. He's the worst! M-Tash. Oh, don't get me started with M-Tash. Always claiming that this changes everything when it changes nothing! Nothing at all! He's the worst. And Mr. Pokey. He's the worst of them all. You want to talk about plagiarism? All he does is plagiarism. Stealing all the content of the Chinese servers. Oh, I can't stand any of these guys. They're the worst. Now, guys, as funny as that is, I would like to remind you that there are people on the internet who be dead ass like that. Not a game. All right.
Real that have either stolen my work or have attacked me. So yeah, as a relatively new content creator, these experiences.
Let's go back. Hold on.
My work or have attacked me.
So they've stolen his work or have attacked him. Okay.
Content creator, these experiences have made it hard for me to make content, and I just don't feel safe making content. And I'm even scared of talking about my experience in this video now, but it's been eating at me for months. So.
ZMM, I want you to do one thing for me, my boy. I want you to hold up whichever hand is your dominant hand. Let's say it's the right one. I want you to take that hand, grab your sack, make sure it's intact and present. And I'm gonna need you to never say that pussy shit again. All right, cool. Let's get back to it.
So I'll just say my piece and leave it at that. We got content police on high patrol today.
He didn't create the strategy. CN players found it first. Should cut that part because it's cringe. God, bro, man, shut your dumb ass up and get off the internet, bro. Like, holy, nothing is more cringe than this. Do you think we all just sit here on the internet like you and we watch every single bit of Hoyoverse content across the skies, across the realms of Asgard, high and low, searching high and wide for every bit of content, not only on the Western side, but also in China? Do you think we sit here and do that shit like you know? Some of us have a life, okay? I don't even watch content from Bilibili. Literally zero. So how the hell are we supposed to know what they found over there? Also, news flash, my boy. Found it first. Just because they uploaded it to the internet doesn't mean they found it first. It means they uploaded it to the internet first. So all this shit is low-key just incredibly cringe. Good lord, bro.
A nasty comment. However, this is a small fish in a bigger pond. And there are more serious misinformation and accusations that I
link my sources and give everyone involved proper credit. I know what it feels like to have my guy remade and get zero credit. My initial free-to-play remembrance strat for Swarm got reused more time than a toilet. And see, this is exactly what I'm talking about. Bro, your free-to-play remembrance strat? Remembrance? My boy, I made a remembrance video. For all I know, it got reused 800 times. Dude, 80% of content creators on the internet are by natural laws of just thinking and playing the same game for hours upon hours are eventually gonna come across the same conclusions, bro. Y'all aren't Einstein. Good lord, this is crazy.
I want to clarify in just a second. So if you guys,
I'm gonna let him cook. I'm just saying this type of shit, it kind of tilts me, bro. It's just like, bro, y'all gatekeeping who's. It's like me reading a description on a character and saying, and the description says this character uses a skill, he'll follow up, and I get on the internet and I say it first, and anybody who says it after me is copying me, and they're still in my work.
Didn't know I made a video about gold and gears.
I'm gonna let him cook.
That got a lot of attraction. In the video, I did a condensed showcase of a run using my strategy in combination with a strategy that I referenced from, shout out to Nagfrog, who showcased that his strategy is overpowered. I gave Nag all the credit. He commented and applauded my video. And if you don't know who Nagfrog is, he's a very talented guide maker. I saw one of his videos a couple of weeks ago, and to show my support, I said this: clear and concise explanation. You should do character guides. You would rock. However,
I like this. This is respect from me for ZMM, because I'm a big fan of people getting credit where credit is due. I'm a big fan of not stealing work, just having integrity, just doing the right damn thing, bro. So I respect this. I also respect creators who go out of their way to comment on other creators' channels because they watch their content. A lot of creators, you'd be surprised, don't do this. Myself too. I'll call myself out on this. I watch people's content and don't comment enough, and I need to do a better job at that. Just letting them know it feels good. It costs nothing, bro, to support our kings and queens out here. But I like the fact that he comments on that. Like, shout out to Io. Io's always commenting on my videos and giving support. It's a beautiful thing that a lot of people don't do enough in the content creation space.
We got a few people coming into my comment section saying that this strategy originated from CN, because in the video I said Nack's strategy is good. Nack, your strategy is kind of insane, dude. The most insane strategy discovered by Nagfrag. He's an awesome guide maker, and I credited the strategy to Nack, which in my opinion is still correct. Nack was the first to pioneer the shop strategy in global, where I saw it first. But I said if someone can link me a CN source, I will credit them as well. So I ignored it until someone provided a actual source, like a CN creator that did the strategy. Which
I don't give a damn who they created. I don't care who they cited over there in CN. I don't watch CN content. I don't give a flying who over there thought of the strategy. That does not mean that I didn't think of it as well. It's so ridiculous.
I looked at their content, and they did go over buying out the shop strategy, which, fair enough. I was like, okay, that's fine. I updated my sources to include them as well. So shout out to Better Than Nothing. The quality of their videos are amazing.
Respect to this guy. Big respect. I wouldn't have done that shit. For what? Like, bro, if you genuinely thought of it yourself, I don't care if I'm the second or third to bring it to the internet. This is why I don't watch anybody else's content, man. This is why I literally just stay in my own lane, because there's no way for you to recreate something that only I have thought of myself. You know what I'm saying? Like, and this is the thing. You can, but it's never going to be the exact same thing, because I literally intentionally avoid watching everybody else's stuff so that they don't like pollute my thoughts, and I unconsciously create some content with that influence, whether I want to admit it or not.
As well, and they're very much god tier. And so, yeah,
it's actually pretty important.
I credit them as the to be based usage of this strategy, and next guide as my reference for my showcase. More importantly, people have the right to provide other sources as well, and I do my best to exercise due diligence.
They also discovered the Ruan mate. Like, how? Who are you? Oh, I gotta stop pausing. That's go really. We're gonna turn this into a 2-hour video. I keep reacting to this.
Or pioneer strategy and have it remade and not get a single credit for it. Now this is where it gets spicy. As you all know, I am a free to play.
So just for people who didn't know, when he said copy and then yoink and twist is transformative to a degree. So it's I actually don't even think it's bad at all. As long as you take it and transform it, you're good, right? Yoink and twist can be considered a React content. But copycatting is just taking somebody's content outright and just straight up, you know, nothing has changed. You just straight up took their idea, hard work, blood, sweat, and tears, and just claimed it as your own.
The content creator for the most part. I mean, I do have 3 accounts, and you know, a whale and 2 free to play, but that's not the point. But if you were here when Swarm Disaster first came out, you probably saw this thumbnail. This was my Swarm Disaster guide.
I've never seen this thumbnail.
A very unique strategy using F2P characters and the Path of Remembrance. At the time, people knew the Path of Remembrance, but not many people played it. So the combination of this F2P team plus the path.
I remember, and this is getting off topic. I made a remembrance guide for when World 7 of the regular simulated universe released. I have no idea. This really puts things in perspective for me, because I don't go on the internet just looking at everybody's content. I wonder how many people thought of that idea before me or after me, or who maybe even stole my own shit. I'm completely oblivious of this, but it's putting things into perspective for me. Maybe I do need to start seeing who's stealing my content. Nah, I don't give a fuck.
Remembrance was quite unique. Sadly, back then, Herta wasn't the most built character like she is now. So when I released the strategy, it was the first of its kind, and it popped off. Until, of course, a fewer bigger creators.
267,000. Damn.
Claiming it was never has to be used like that. Strategy. Using fairly similar teams and explanations 1 to 3 days after mine. This is what most people would consider a proper way.
Okay, this is still a stretch. I'm going to let him cook, but it's still a stretch for you to claim that he stole your content because he uploaded it 1 to 2 days after your content. It is very possible in the likelihood that thousands of content creators making content for a game can upload in the same time period, because surprise, it takes the same amount of time to make that video. I'm not saying this is what happened. What I'm saying is this is still a reach and not good enough conclusive evidence to condemn somebody for what appears to be plagiarism.
Joining and twisting.
YouTube is a beautiful cesspool of inspiration, remixing, riffing, parody. Drawing on existing ideas is a great way of making something new and unique. It's only wrong when you add nothing and try to pretend it was yours in the first place. And you don't have to cite your sources like...
The accent along with how he was tilting his head and looking makes that so much funnier.
Rocket scientist either.
However, this bigger creator, Artumbo, did not yoink and twist, but instead he just yoinked. He just straight up...
37.5k subs, objectively, compared to, I think this guy's at 20k. Yeah. I don't know. A bit of a stretch.
Stole my guide without an ounce of credit, gaining as many views as the original guide, while my video...
Dude, that is... Bro, that's bad. And I'm gonna increase the severity and seriousness of this situation, but goddamn, if this is true, that's bad.
Oh, my video has to essentially compete with my video.
It's like the most blatant...
That he stole my guide, though. Oh boy, let me tell you, this guy would make the absolute worst criminal. Like, I'm talking about, like, the type to rob a convenience store while asking if they sell ski masks. Okay, so 2 to 3 days after my guide was published, Artumbo releases his...
Okay, here we go. 18.5 to 37. Yeah, you know what? Double his size. Yeah, okay. I feel him for saying that. Double his size, I get it.
Disaster guide, where he went ahead and used the exact characters and the exact path that I did, the path of remembrance. So obviously, that's already a red flag.
Okay, again, it's still a bit of a reach here for me. Okay, the reason I say this is a reach is because there's only one free-to-play remembrance team to run. Okay, it's Pella, March, Herta. Yeah, it's like, what else are you gonna run as a free-to-play remembrance team? That's literally it. That's the only team you can think of. It's not like there's 18 different free-to-play remembrance teams. There's only one team.
That I did, the path of remembrance. So obviously, that's...
But now the context he mentioned earlier makes more sense.
Already a red flag. However, a bigger piece of evidence is that in his guide, he brags about how he's able to clear content while his Herta has level 1 traces.
Unless you have a cracked Herta. I didn't level any of her traces up pretty much, and you'll see that in the build section later.
So he decided that his unbuilt Herta is good enough to beat Swarm 5. Like, you just don't go, oh, let's just use my unbuilt Herta, who I never played in my life before.
Yeah, nah, bro. Hell nah.
To beat Swarm 5, unless you've seen the strategy before and you saw the limits of how the strategy works from someone else.
Oh no, this is turning sour real fast, guys.
Well, you're probably like, okay, well, Zeto, maybe he had some spidey senses about Herta, and maybe he tried the strategy all day to understand the ins, outs, and limits of it in order to make a guide in one day.
Hey, listen, I've done it before, guys. I'll say it. I've been in MOC floor 10 for 8 hours straight trying to get a zero cycle just to prove a point, all right? It is possible. It's possible. But ain't no way.
No. Like I said, this idiot would make the worst damn criminal in the world. He had to go and brag that this is his first attempt.
I think it was my first attempt.
Hey guys, listen. First try, all right? Chat. Make sure you tell him it was my first try, okay? First try, unbuilt Herta. Never did this strategy before. First try. Now listen. If you like me, you really can first try. All right, I'm not about to do that shit. Okay, hold on.
Let's go. Do have them built for damage like a Herta. I will be building Herta for damage, but right now she's not.
You can't make this up. First time Herta, first attempt, exact same team as mine, same run strategies.
Oh no.
Typically with their most tanky stats, so defense body, defense orbs, HP orbs.
You do want to be building all your characters with an HP or defense body and orb,
because you're not trying to deal damage, you're trying to survive.
You do not need any damage percent. You are trying to survive.
Same blessing player.
Yo! Artumbo! Ain't no way, my boy! Yeah, it's not a good look, bro. Honestly, at this point, I'm sold. Yeah, completely sold. Not only does the timing add up and everything he's laid out, this man's good. He's good. He's good as me. He provides the points like to, in a way where there's no way you can't track them and come up to the conclusion that, yep, this verdict is guilty. Guilty! That is guilty!
And he's not crediting a soul. Lord, he's either a liar or he is the second coming of Jesus. No. Actually, you guys are right. Let's give him the benefit of the doubt. So let's say he got all of that first try and God told him everything he needed to know about the strategy beforehand. And that,
yeah, listen, guys, it's possible, right? It's possible. This is the kind of copium and denial that Genshin stands will do for Genshin Impact, right? When they say that in-game's coming or that Genshin's still not as bad as you say, they go to the utmost extremes when all the evidence has been laid upon.
It was just a pure coincidence. He used the exact same F2P team as me. Can't get any worse, right? Can't be any more ridiculous, right? Don't worry. This will either blow your mind or get you laughing like crazy because of how stupid I am. So in my guide, I said this about the final enemy. Frusting has almost 100% resistance to crowd control. So when I said the enemies have almost 100% resist to crowd control, I was actually talking out of my ass. I did not know what I was talking about.
Hey, bro, I've done it before, man. You know, it's like you got, it's what you call, the feels crafting. You're like, yeah, you know, that those numbers look good enough. It's a possibility. But what's sad about me is I actually know how to calculate everything. My lazy ass don't be feeling like doing it sometimes.
Just pulled out random numbers and words because while testing, the boss resisted quite a few of my freezes. And so I felt like it was you know, I just, hey, you know, hey, it's about 100%, you know? But data on the boss wasn't,
yeah, exactly,
at the time. If it was,
it's about 100%. Hey, you just, yeah, you know what I'm saying? Close enough.
What I said still wouldn't make an ounce of sense because the boss has two separate resistance multipliers. One,
that's true. And this is something that's important to know. Oh, my fat head is in the way just a little bit. Hey, you know what? I'll let him cook.
That is the effect res, which it has 50%. And the
correct,
other,
he highlighted it,
res, which it has 75%. And we can't just add, yeah, these two together because...
And you can also, the debuff res is a control resistance too. Like, so this one up here to 75%. Oh God, I'm getting nerdy already. This one is a representation of anything that pertains to control. Like, so if you try to imprison somebody, if you try to catch them with a freeze, that is gonna be added into the equation. But it's not as simple as 50% plus 75%.
They're multipliers. They're multiplicative values used in the formula to calculate the real chance of freezing.
Yeah, that's the formula, which is on Wikipedia, by the way.
Almost 100% by themselves. And even if we calculated the effect hit rate of our main freezes, either with March or with the path ability, I'll pick March in this case since she has a lower base chance of 65%. And with these very generous assumptions, we would get a
100%
chance to freeze. And if we take the inverse, it would mean the boss has a 71% chance to resist freezes, which isn't close to or almost 100%. So I just proved to you guys what I said was, yeah, made up. And I was stupid for saying something like that without understanding the intricacy of the formula or seeing the actual data. But you know what's more stupid? The guy who regurgitated my bullshit!
Because it pretty much has 100% resist against crowd control.
Has almost...
Oh, no. Bro unintentionally set a trap card that activated in his favor, bro. Oh, my God. And this man fell for the hook, line, and sinker. God Damn, bro. Holy. This has got to be... I'm not going to lie. If I was Artumbo, bro, I'd have to hang it in after this one, bro. Like, dead ass. This is embarrassing. This is very embarrassing, bro. You know what? It sucks because Artumbo has rated me on Twitch like 12 times. I actually like the guy because he's rated me. I've never spoken with him. But damn, this is so unfortunate, man. It truly is. It's a feels bad experience. It's sad to see. And I'm going to get to the severity of this shit and why I'm keeping it lighthearted, but we're going to address the severity of it very soon.
100% resistance to crowd control.
It's only wrong when you add nothing and try to pretend it was yours in the first place.
You can't make this up. The crazy part is if I said the right thing, or if I said something vague, like the enemies have a high chance of resisting freezes, and he copied me, then I wouldn't have caught him.
No, because
it
bro.
Would be too vague.
Yeah, we get it, man. We get it, brother. Bro got caught in the act.
However, because
by presenting wrong information confidently, only because you presented it with confidence. He said, yeah. He said it was right. It got to be right, right? Yeah, it's got to be right.
I said some bullshit. And he thought I actually knew what I was talking about. He copied my bullshit and snitched on himself. You can't make this shit up.
That's embarrassing, man. Holy shit.
I don't remember who said this, but one point on the graph doesn't mean much. But when you get multiple points and it starts to draw a line.
It's hard. It gets harder and harder to deny it. It gets closer and closer to factuals.
Well, I'd say if you ain't bald yet, you're starting to bald.
Nah, bro. Not my boy Asmigo, bro. Bro got the Vegeta going on over there, man. Damn, bro. Bro gotta put an M right here so he can be Majin Vegeta.
This is what happens when you literally copy almost everything from someone else's guide. So if his channel was already way more successful than mine, why do it? Why not give credit, but instead go as far as to steal someone else's guide?
It's not hard to think, honestly. Bro, we don't even have to make this complicated. Why steal someone else's guide and go about it in the manner that he went into? It's simple. Greed. Greed. That's all it is. It's the same thing why you ask somebody, why are you stealing from a store? Greed. You don't need that candy bar or that TV or whatever the hell you stole, but if you can get away with it, then you're going to try and get away with it. At least that's the mindset of a criminal, right? But the thing is, if you're going to do this the way Artumbo did this, it's not like he's doing it in a diabolical way. He did this with the mere thought of, did I get away with it for about a week, right? Probably he was like, probably skating on thin ice for a week himself. This is probably how he felt. And then once he got away with it. He got away with the trick. He didn't get caught. Well, he just continued moving on with his life, right? No matter how much time goes on after that, it's not like he's dreading it after that. It's a moment of making a bad decision. And then praying that that decision never comes back to bite you in the ass. That's pretty much what it is.
The answer is this. Artumbo
copied these people because he thought what they were doing was beneath respect. Plagiarists seem to have this belief they are better than their targets. More important, more deserving of credit. Better politics. A better class of person. Your ideas are wasted on you. They'd be much better served in my videos.
And that's the answer. Thanks, H-Bomber guy. He sees other creators, especially smaller ones.
That's what I'm saying. And don't get me wrong. I'm sure some plagiarists do this. Absolutely. In fact, that makes sense in a lot of situations. I don't think that's the case with Artumbo. I don't think he thinks he's better than you or anything. I think he saw a strategy of yours that was brilliant. And he just tried to get away with it. I really do. I don't think it's that deep. And bro got caught in 4K HD. But I mean, I want to be clear here. I think what he did was absolutely bitch made. I'm just trying to let this man cook so I can eventually get to my own thoughts on this situation.
As beneath him, undeserving of their own work or respect. He's afraid that his viewers will see his low quality content mill, compare it to other creators, and decide, hey, I want to watch them instead. Stealing ideas from others and not crediting them. It's a great...
Yeah, you know what? I do agree with that take. I do. For whatever reason, when people do this shit, and that's actually the reason I'm stopping is that's along lines of thoughts that I was coming to. They have some insecurity that if they don't credit that if they do credit the creator, then their viewers are going to go away, which is not true at all. It's a horrible freaking take. Strategy
to double fuck your smaller competition, really. Not only do you get their ideas, but now they have to compete with themselves.
Yeah, and that's a shitty situation to be in. The thing is, it's infuriating seeing this happen, especially with Artumbo. I've seen his content before. You don't even have to not credit. If you credit the person, your audience will respect you more. You'll bring exposure to the person you're crediting. But it's not like they're going to go, oh, I'm going to go watch that guy now. What's going to happen is they're going to say, oh, so this is the guy who made this brilliant idea. I'll go check his channel out. But I'm still going to watch your reaction or your form of the content because I like your style, your format, and how you present things. I like you in the way you do content. That's why I watch you. So I don't care if he's still... A lot of people, it is the reality, a lot of people will still only watch that creator even if the credit belongs to the other creator just because they like the style of that creator. So it's not really... It's no point in not crediting, man. It's not. They're watching you for a reason.
You research for days to find out the unique strategy, but I deserve it, not you. You're beneath me. So your work is my content now. And the ironic part is...
See, this is when he's starting to like vilify him a bit. I don't know if that's even a word, but trying to like pin him out to be a villain. I don't think he actually believes that. I genuinely don't. He's just an idiot that tried to get away with plagiarism. It's that simple. And he needs to understand the severity of plagiarism, which I'm sure he does now. He probably has a fire lit under his ass.
I used to watch Artumbo's videos. As seen here, I commented on his Asta video. He even responded, so I know he definitely knew about my channel. But yet he still stole even from his viewer, banking on the hope that...
Glad you noticed all four Harmony characters released right now on the same team.
Remained silent. And yeah, he was right. I was a coward and I remained silent for 4 months. Getting double Artumbo did to me really makes a creator not want to create any content. Because if you put out something and he copies it, now you're competing with yourself.
And that is one incredibly shitty feeling, especially if you are a very small content creator. Because I think that's probably one of the most infuriating things about this experience. It's the idea of... As a content creator, everyone, including Artumbo, we should understand the blood, sweat, and tears, the risk, the time invested into this business, and just how hard it is, not only to create the content, but to battle the algorithm, right? So when you do something that Artumbo has done, to the degree that he's done it in terms of the plagiarism, it is the ultimate disrespect and slap in the face, not only to the other creator, but to yourself. You should know better. You know what I mean? Like, bro, that is the most fake, snake, cowardice shit I've seen. This is the thing, and I want to get this across vividly, explicitly clear. Most of the content that gets put out in games like this and in spaces like this, 80% of it is unanimously agreed upon and the conclusion has already been drawn by everybody. What we're working to do as creators is on the 20% that differentiates you from the other creators. It's what brings the viewer to you because you have somehow put in the work, blood, sweat, and tears, and grind to find things that actually separate you from the other creators. That's what gives you the value and that's what truly grows you as a creator. But when somebody like Artumbo comes along, takes your 20%, which is the most valuable thing, takes it for himself, gives you no credit, now you see why I'm saying it's the biggest disgrace and slap in the face to that creator. That's why plagiarism is completely unacceptable in this space, most importantly.
Ate me up for months. After that incident, I really wasn't motivated to make content, and so there was a...
Eaten up for months is wild. DMM, I need you to remember what I said at the beginning of the video, brother. Right hand, sack. Remind yourself that you're a man. That shit is not what men do, okay?
Big 20-day content gap between this video and the next one, right? And that feeling sucks, and I don't wish that on anybody. And so I try to do my due diligence, crediting Knack and Better Than Nothing when I did my showcase. Because it's important to respect others instead of seeing them as beneath you. Instead of stealing their flowers. And the grim reality is this. The only way to combat someone taking our work is to talk about it. And let the public, let you guys, the viewers, decide for yourself if it's wrong or not. So that's what I'm doing.
Brother, beautifully said. I couldn't agree more. This is precisely why you go to public. And I already know you're probably dealing with a lot of these people from these creator spaces who are literal mentally ill, dumb, who don't understand that concept. This is the thing. You went public with it for what you just mentioned, but also because if you did not go public with it, they would have got away with that shit. And the public would have continued putting these people on pedestals like they're perfect human beings that do no wrong and they have the utmost, image. Their image is unblemished, right? They do nothing wrong. They're saints. This is also why you go public. To show these dumb motherfuckers who put these people on platforms that, no, not really. Boy, do I got a surprise for you.
All I can do is to share my experience and But why now, Zeto? Also, you're making it sound like he's doing this to other creators too. Or you have at least...
I wouldn't put it past him at this point. And it sucks to say that because I'm not trying to... It really is painful giving an objective take on this situation, which is inevitably going to put these creators in negative lights. Because I genuinely like them. I'm not kidding. But I don't put it past them after this. You don't. Because the first thing that comes to mind is, well, what else did he get away with? Seriously. That's going to come to mind because if he's doing it with this person, he's probably doing it with other people because it's been working. And once you start drinking or taking the apple from that tree and it tastes good, you're going to start doing it again because the views and the success are actually carrying the channel.
Or you have at least another example, right? That's where the climax comes in. But to truly experience the climax, we must first understand how I got attacked by a bear behind my back. So as you guys...
Oh... Little bear. No, man. Oh, no. Did ZMM just remake your vid? What do the pains mean? What the hell does that mean? But okay, so did ZMM just remake your vid? Knackfry. Tag Knackfrog. This is unacceptable. This is absolutely unacceptable. This is severe. And if it's in a public forum, it's incredibly severe. You're accusing a content creator of plagiarism. Right now, in real time, you guys are seeing the consequences and the severity of plagiarism when it is indeed true. Right now, you see Artumbo, again, has a fire lit under his ass. It is not an exaggeration to say that his livelihood of his channel is possibly at stake, because guess what? I would argue 50 to possibly 75% of a content creator's success is directly tied to the reputation that they've spent so long building up, the integrity that they've spent so long building up. Once you tear that off of a content creator and you turn that image against them, the livelihood of their channel is very much in danger. This is why it's incredibly important that you do not falsely accuse somebody of plagiarism, especially a content creator in a public goddamn space. Let's see and let's continue on.
Probably saw in the thumbnail, Little Bear, drama certified, he's back again. You thought...
I love the fact that Little Bear stemmed for me, bro. And it's used only when it's used to obviously belittle somebody, but it's only used when it's necessary, right? Guoba is demonstrating that he's doing Little Bear things, bro. Breaks my heart.
You would learn from inciting drama in the public space with Mr. Smack. Oh no, oh no.
Okay, hold on, man. This is such a crazy situation right here. I link my sources and I give everyone involved proper credit. I know what it feels like to have my guide remade and get zero credit. My initial free-to-play remembered strat for Swarm got reused more time than a toilet. So this is his response to, did ZMM just remake your vid? And I guess he did it days in advance. And I guess the response to that is holy back reading. Is that all right at the bottom there? Holy back reading, all right. So, did he even apologize? after publicly accusing this man of plagiarism, did he even apologize right there? Or did he just say, oh, okay, cool. You know what? Let me get on the internet and M-Tash, you stealing my content, bro. Hey, man, public. Let me go to 18 different communities. M-Tash, you stealing my content, bro. Do you have evidence of that? No. Bro, he's not stealing your content. Oh, he's not? All right, cool. Cool, he's not stealing my content. Let me just nonchalantly threaten the livelihood of another man's channel. Let's just do that.
He's back on form, ladies and gentlemen. He's back. He went from policing misinformation to policing content between two creators who did not have any content issues. Even after Knack commented, applauded my take on the strategy, and gave me his seal of approval. Content police certified had to accuse me of stealing Knack's video that I remade.
Content police certified.
Look at the tone that he says this. Knack Frog, did ZMM just remake your vid? Frog emoji. What do the pains
mean? Wait. I'm sorry.
Had to accuse me of stealing Knack's video that I remade Knack's
okay,
video.
Okay.
Look at the tone that he says this. Knack Frog, did ZMM just remake your vid? Frog emoji. What do the pains mean? Knack himself did not fall for the drama bait. He said, yeah, I got credit, all good. And then he says, I'm sure there were plenty of people who figured it out anyway. I was just the first to share.
Thank you. Somebody with common sense with these dumbasses talk about CN found it first. Oh my, this is literally what I was saying. There's plenty of people who probably figured out. Thank you. Somebody with common sense. Oh my God, Knack, if you're watching this video, thank you, buddy. Thank you for having common sense.
So the GigaChat himself doesn't take the bait. Oh, by the
way. Oh, and this is huge because now he just completely shut down the false plagiarism claims to Guoba, who accused this guy of this.
By the way, instead of doing this privately, forgot this was public certified, said all of.
First of all, he cooking this by these names.
This in a.
But he has went. Oh my God, dude. Oh, say it ain't so.
The Star DB general chat. You can't make this shit up. Like, you can go look at it right now and it's there.
Oh my. That is not a good look, bro. Oh no. The first thing that comes to mind, you guys, is I talked to this kid about this shit on my podcast. I literally told him, you cannot go public with slander and misrepresentation of another creator because you are attacking their goddamn life points directly. You are affecting the livelihood of their channel. What if this man has to pay bills and this is his only source of income? What if he has a family to provide? You can't do this shit, man. This is not okay. This literally, it pisses me off, bro. And it's not like it's at this point, man, it's not no, oh, I'm a kid, I make mistakes. No, bro, that you need to be held accountable. Get your goofy ass off Discord and stop talking behind people's backs like a little bitch, man. What are you doing? This is, bro, this is a man's livelihood. It is. This is the thing. Me, this shit looks just as bad as the plagiarism to me, because y'all don't understand how a forest fire begins. It doesn't start off engulfed in flames. It starts off with one little fire. And if that fire is potent enough, it spreads. And before you know it, it engulfs the entire forest in flames. This motherfucker is starting the fire right now. And then he gets called out and he doesn't apologize. All right. That's crazy. So I just tried to start a fire to burn the forest down. The forest is ZMM. He blew it out and said, what are you doing? And you didn't even apologize. That is insane to me, bro.
And when I called out the backstabber for it, he just said, oh, back reading, nervous Pepe emoji.
Nah, so hell no, bro. Oh, that shit is actually tilting me, man.
He catch his ass in 4K.
Bro.
I personally reached out to Knack in private, even though he said he was all right with it. Even though he said he told you it was okay.
But I got to sit on that for a bit.
Because that's the right way to do it. And he said this, no, that's all good. There's no way I can lay claim to a way to play the game. I enjoyed watching your take on it. Quite entertaining. Appreciate the shout out. Man, I've never seen so much GigaChat energy in my life. Also, Guoba claimed that I remade the video. I just referenced the dice strategy and mixed it with my own teams using the preservation team to do.
First of all, it's not even, oh, that's a lot of damage. God damn, that's a lot of damage. That's gotta be like It's got to be a dissociation. First of all, yeah, so many things wrong with that, bro. Why couldn't you? This is a why couldn't you DM situation. This is literally a why. Why couldn't you just DM Knack privately and say, hey, bro, did you check this video out? Did he by any chance steal that? Oh, he didn't? Okay, cool. Bro, the public shit, I need y'all to understand the severity of this, man. Like, again, it's the 4 is 5 situation. Other people in the Discord who aren't mature, who are morons, are going to take that information. They're not going to verify it. And they're going to gossip across the spans of several Discords and communities within the community of Honkai Star Rail. And then that shit becomes true if nobody checks it. And if he never saw this, guess what? People would have ran with it. That's simple. That's how misinformation begins. That's literally the foundation and concoction of misinformation, bro. No verification. Oh, this is what happened. Gossip. How do you think the foundation of marketing began? It began through word of mouth and gossip. And then it transformed into the internet now, but it's still the same thing. It's still the same concept. Word of mouth and spread like a wildfire.
The showcase with my own take on it. Like Knack said, I enjoyed your take on it. If you just watched the first 35 seconds of the video or saw the credits or looked at the comment section where Knack approved of it, you would have realized there's nothing to police here. And even if you didn't see the video, why are you putting my name in your mouth? Where?
Yeah, that's another thing that's annoying. Mind your business, bro. Mind your mother business, man.
Where is mind your own business certified when you need him?
That's exactly what I said, bro. But
instead, we get attack in public certified. It's ridiculous. What is wrong with you? Imagine if
this dad is roasted his name, bro.
Said this shit in public space behind someone's back like Tectone, Mtash, Brax. He knows it would be game over for him. So he gotta do it to a smaller creator like me. But hey, you picked the wrong dog to ruffle the fence with today.
I remember. I'm proud of you for standing up. This is what I'm saying. Yes, for standing up. Stand up for yourself, man. Don't back down like a little bitch.
I told Gacha Smack and his Discord that he didn't like replying.
Hey, come on, man. You telling me out of all the pictures you could have got, you gonna get me with this goddamn picture right here, bro? I look high as a motherfucking kite. Come on, my boy. What's going on here? I'm not replying to drama or being a part of it. They can get their views. I do my content. Yeah, I mean, I don't like pulling up past stuff. We've moved on from it, but this is an appropriate time to actually pull it up. Because again, this shows, well, but you're full of shit. You know what I mean? This is a ruse to convince your audience to not taint that image that you're trying so hard to keep. And then you just, for whatever reason, decide to just tear it all down, bro.
Or being part of drama that they can get their views, I'll do my content. Yet he goes and falsely attacks another creator's content just to get what? 8 ayaya emotes? That's more pathetic than getting views. The hypocrisy and ego of this guy is bigger than No Man's Sky. It's like I'm endorsing a smaller creator and...
I don't understand it either. Again, I talked to him about the... Like, you're succeeding. You're a guide maker, which means people come to you for information. They don't come to you for takes outside of your guides and information. And they're doing well. He's literally one of the most successful guide makers in the space. He's doing so well. There's literally no need for, I said this shit word for word in the podcast. There's no need to do any of this. Just mind your damn business, bro. You already have succeeded at what many other creators in the guide space are trying to succeed at. What is the purpose of this, my boy?
Content Police Certified drives by and says, sorry, I don't like this. You gotta go to content jail now.
You expect it from the randoms, but you don't expect it from another content creator.
The ironic part is no one is saying this.
You know.
Like none of you guys who watch my videos are saying this. And not even randoms did this. Except Guoba, who is arguably the top 3 biggest Star Rail creators.
And that's what's so wild and so unacceptable about it. Your name and you... I think the only way y'all are going to understand this is just imagine me. Which, thank God I don't. Just imagine me. A lot of people respect me for my takes, they're very rational and pragmatic. And I've built up a reputation and integrity where people trust me to weigh in on situations and not, you know, do some fakes, bitch made snake shit, right? But imagine me with that kind of reputation going into communities and just bad mouthing people. If it's me doing it, it's It is apps. I have weight with my words. I actually have an influence, a strong influence on a lot of people. They're going to take what I'm saying more, way more serious than just some person who hasn't made a name for themselves. And they're going to take what I'm saying, believe in it, be influenced by it. And now this content creator is in real time getting slandered thanks to me. How I've talked with you about this, and you're a grown ass man. I'm going to treat you like a grown ass man. I would slap the shit out of you if I was ZMM and we were in person, because this is not okay, man. I can't stress like this to you guys.
Risk their whole entire reputation to stroke their ego over others. This is poor form, little bear. If it's two things I hate the most,
poor form. That's what he told me.
Put others down to make themselves feel better, and people telling me what to do when they don't have the right to. All right. So my friend was right. It doesn't matter what Guoba's opinion is, as long as Knack and I have no issues with it. This
That's 100%. Bro was literally out here going out of his way.
Reminds me of that, like that one soul dude who literally self-inserted himself into Tekton's business to incite drama when Tekton and the other creator already hashed it out.
It's called Steak and Eggs.
You like that?
And my opinion of you changed because I was like, okay, well, when he's not talking about Genshin.
Great podcast, by the way. I tune into it every now. I've actually missed a couple of episodes. I got to catch up, but a great podcast. Between Tekton, Asmongold, and another creator named Imaru. I enjoy it.
He's not making a fucking clown of himself. So he's
still, you're probably
that's face, bro. Light work, no reaction.
When he's not talking about Genshin, he's not making a fucking clown of himself. So he's still
I don't know why that's way funnier than it should be to me.
You're probably one
the eyebrow so twitch,
he's
bro.
Talking about Genshin, he's not making a fucking clown of himself. So he's
still
Hey, I'm sorry, man. That probably shit is funny, bro.
Zeto, why did you put Artumbo and Guoba in the same video? Well, you guessed it. They are creators that have supported each other on multiple collabs, and they have commented on each other.
Oh, no, not the conspiracy theory, bro.
There's videos constantly. So we know that they are friends. At least on the creator level. And in that case, the one, Guoba Certified got a friend who steals, remakes videos, and does not credit. And two, we all know Content Police Certified loves to call out people in public for remaking videos. Well, send me to Facebook Live and call me a conspiracy theorist, but there might be a correlation here. If you ask me what 1 + 2 is, I'd say 5. And that brings us to the climax.
That's actually funny. What he's saying is he's willing to make the reach that this is all like coordinated, which... Yeah, I would never do that. It's a funny thing for him to do, and I think there's no wrong in the levels of extremity that he's taking in this regard because of how he just got straight dogged out, right, by both of these guys. But I would never do that. I would never jump to that conclusion. I need fine evidence. I'm like L, bro, from Death Note.
Doing it again? The Yoink and Artumbo? Say it ain't so. Okay, so someone tipped me off and says that Artumbo posted a video of the same exact strategy that I referenced that Knack made and stuff like that. And it's the same strategy that you saw Guoba saying I stole. He's doing that right now. What a surprise. It's the capitalism strategy that Knack wrote and that I credit Knack, but... The funny part is, he didn't credit anybody on this. He didn't say, hey, I saw it from here.
What am I looking at?
I'm pretty sure he's not referencing anything.
Put a Smeagol in there.
We're all beneath him, right? You know?
Yeah, this is just, it's such cowardice, bro. It is. It really is, man. Artumbo and Guoba, I need y'all to grab whichever hand is dominant. I need you to place that bad boy right here. I need you to grab your ball sack. It's possible that you do not have one. If you do, remind yourself that you are a goddamn man and this isn't what men do.
What? Let's go ask Guoba. Ask Guoba about it. So yeah, I painfully watched the full video and he used the exact strategy that Knack provided and even labels one of the chapters capitalism. It doesn't mention Knack at all. Doesn't link his YouTube or say it anywhere. So the very same strategy that Guoba accused me of stealing and remaking from Knack, even though I gave everyone credit and Knack approved, is now being taken by Artumbo, who didn't reference anyone. Not even CN players. This is your guy, Guoba. Wait, I know.
Yeah, that's your mans. Get your mans. Content
police certified condemned Artumbo like he did me in a public Discord chat, right?
Oh, he did.
This one. Nope. Not this one.
Everyone will get one when my graphics guy is not busy. All right, holy battery. Nope.
Not this one either. Actually, here's a good idea. Hey, Guoba, at Guoba, did Artumbo just remake next video without an ounce of...
Send it through. You won't send
Reddit.
It. You ain't gonna send it.
Oh, no, I'm not that petty. I'm not that... he said this. Sadly, I figured that kind of behavior...
That would be, if he did it, 100% necessary. I wouldn't even blame him. Because again, bro publicly slandered you. You come back with the same goddamn energy.
Fear would be more common than not.
So except your energy is actually appropriate. And it's not even bad. It's the truth.
Actually surprised to get mentioned at all in your video. So yeah, Artumbo would rather step on them, take their belongings, and claim it as his own since we are basically beneath him. Double standard certified. You held me a higher standard than our Artumbo.
Bro, this man.
Called me out for endorsing and crediting.
I was subscribed to this man after this video.
At your friend who-
Bro has been roasting Guoba all day with these names.
Steals from the smaller creators you champion to help. And back to the climax. Well, Guoba, since you're such a champion of the smaller creators, you also know our story and you love calling people out in public for remaking videos, I would be so happy if you can call out your friend Artumbo. And maybe in one of your guys' meme craft collab, you can ask him, hey Artumbo, did you steal DMM, Knack, and other creators' videos? And please do this publicly, because you seem to love the clout. So now, Guoba, that's what pain really means. Not being credited.
It's true, though. I think and it's, again, this shit pains me, bro. Like, I'm going to show y'all something. It's not anything ridiculous. It's actually a good thing. It's a good thing for Guoba. He checks in on me frequently on Discord all the time. Now, I'll be honest. I've always had a bit of skepticism with Guoba after our situation. Naturally, because the way he went about it, again, I tell you, it's like snake type of stuff. And once that happens... It's like I have a bit of a defensive barrier with those kind of people. And I keep cool with them. I keep cordial with them. But I keep my guard up because I don't think they can be trusted. People who go in Discords and do all this goddamn yapping about other individuals. Denzel said it best. Great minds discuss ideas. Good minds discuss events. Small minds, I repeat, small minds discuss other people. You got your ass in the Discord yapping and talking behind people's backs. You got my... going in a YouTube comment section talking trash about another creator for an hour straight back and forth up till 6 a.m. in the morning. These people are pathetic cowards. They're not deserving of any recognition or respect. So when this type of thing happens, you're like, my trust in you is not only like completely shattered, it's hard for me to trust other creators. This is bitch made, bro. I wasn't grown up to do this. Like, I can yap about it all day. It's just ridiculous, man.
My professor once said, when you climb that ladder, don't pull it up. Hold it down like how others have held it down for you.
He's showing all the creators comment on his channel and stuff.
And I've learned to cherish those words.
Yep, respect. Respect.
Passing down the torch and helping others like how others have helped me. So for Guoba, I hope he learns to be more self-aware. He's a very talented and hardworking guide maker.
It's not a good look, man, because it's the second time it happened. He was told what not to do, and he still did that shit. I'm sorry, man. This here for me, three strikes, you're out. I don't even need three strikes, bro. This is a bitter taste in my mouth, bro.
He grow his ego into an ego that has...
It's just so unnecessary.
Self-respect as well as respect for others and avoid going down the wrong
path. But I tell you what, guys.
So, yeah, that's my story. I don't know.
This is like, first of all, that's a fantastic video. I feel like that's pretty much the gist of it. Got anything else? I feel like that's the gist of it, man. My honest thoughts after watching that video, I seen the public apologies made by both Artumbo and Guoba. I didn't even read them. I just saw them. They popped up on my newsfeed. Furthermore, Guoba himself DM'd me on Discord trying to reconcile a situation with this guy, and he knew I was probably going to react to it. And I didn't respond to that because I wanted to get a good grasp on the situation first. I had some skepticism of, something being brought to my attention like that seems like a desperate move. So I looked into it right now. And yeah, after we seen all that, I think the most disappointing thing to me is this after the fact, you know, I'm sorry game they like to play. This is, again, why I love the going public sit scheme. They're not sorry. They're sorry they got caught. And because you went public, they're now in fear of the livelihoods of not only their channel, but their reputation. And now they're in panic mode. And now it's, oh, I'm so sorry. Oh, I swear I'm not a bad person. You're only doing all of this because now it has been publicly put out there for people to see those true colors. And that's what I don't respect, man. I'm just like, there's nothing that they can say in those apologies that is going to cleanse this whole ordeal for me. That your apology at this particular point is weightless. I'm sorry. If you wanted to apologize, you could have apologized in that Discord after you straight up accused him of plagiarism that wasn't true. The other guy could have apologized within the week of after uploading it, man. You guys knew what the hell you were doing at the time. You weren't apologetic. And then that is the accountability that I'm going to, you know, weigh in on heavily. But you guys let me know. Comment down below. I'd love to hear your thoughts. Do I think that Guoba's channel is at stake here? No. You know why? I'll give you a quick little reason. Guide makers get a lot of views for a reason. It's because their guides are incredibly neutral, objective, positive. They don't say anything negative. They give the information. And the people who are watching these guides are all kinds of people from all walks of life. Dickheads, douchebags, people just trying to understand how to play a game. What I'm trying to say here is it's also majorly filled with people who are addicted to the game that you're covering. They don't care about you because your entire business is ran off of your personality not even being in there, or if it's barely in there, if at all. And you've given them the only reason to just watch your guides. That's it. So as long as you continue making guides, it doesn't matter if you're a douchebag, a scumbag, whatever the case may be, they're still going to watch your guides. They can talk a good game like, oh, do better and all this. They ain't going no goddamn where, regardless of whether you were a shithead or not. So them views ain't going nowhere. But this is what I will tell you. Your reputation has taken a dive. And as soon as you stop making those guides, the first thing that I remember is this bad publicity and the things you've done. And that's all she wrote. That's the truth. Now, Artumbo, on the other hand, the plagiarism thing, his channel was definitely, his livelihood is definitely at stake. Now, you can make a recovery. You could. Again, this is the Hoyoverse audience. These people love Hoyoverse games. As long as you're making content, they're probably still going to stick around. So we'll see what happens. At the end of the day, I'm only one man giving one man's perspective. But those are all of my true, honest, and unfiltered raw thoughts and emotions on this particular topic. I'm going to hit the hay, watch some anime, knock out some dailies, and yeah, I'm out.